morning. Welcome to Champlin United Methodist Church. We're delighted that you've joined us today. My name's Max Richter, and I'm pastor here, and we are very proud to say that here at Champlin UMC, we are a progressive and inclusive congregation here in the Northwest Metro. We're so happy that you've joined us today. We open our hearts and our lives to God in worship this morning.
For today, I will not worry what tomorrow will bring. I'm gonna try something new and walk through this day like I've got nothing to prove.
Although I have the best intentions, can't predict anyone's reactions, so I just do my best. I put one foot in front of the other, keep on moving forward, and let God do the rest. I don't know what's gonna happen, that's all right with me. I open up my arms and I embrace the mystery. I don't know what's gonna happen, that's all right with me. I open up my arms and I embrace the mystery.
It's okay not to know. Exploration.
I open up my arms and I embrace the mystery. I don't know what's gonna happen, that's all right with me. I open up my arms and I embrace the mystery.
Amen. Want to invite all the kids to gather around for children's time. We're so glad that you're with us today. So, how did school go this week? We have sure been thinking about you and praying for your parents and for your teachers. Whether you're doing distance learning or a hybrid program or whatever is going to come this week, we love you and you are in our prayers as you continue to begin this new school year. So I think one of the things that's important as we are all learning, that's for people of all ages, including us grown-ups, is that sometimes we need to take a break from our lessons too. And so I'm wondering, has there been anybody that's gotten outside this week? It's been a really beautiful time. And one of the wonderful ways that we can pray, especially during a beautiful fall like this, is to go for a walk and notice all the beautiful things that God has made. So that is my challenge for you this week, to go for a walk every day and try to find three beautiful things that God has made and thank God for those things. So it could be some beautiful fall leaves. It could be a bird you've never seen before. It might be some animal that is on your block. Maybe there's a neighbor dog you want to say hello to. Whatever it is that God has made, give thanks and know that it's our job to help care for all of God's creation, all the things that God has made. Again, we love you. Have a good week, and God goes with you, and we do too. Amen. us join one another in this call to worship as we welcome God's presence in our midst. We may be thirsty and parched like an unwatered garden, so we come into God's presence. The Divine One is a spring of water. We may be weary from worry and work, so we come into God's presence. The Holy One offers us Sabbath rest. We may be lost or confused, so we come into God's presence. The Wise One offers welcome and guidance. We may be bent over with struggle or pain, and so we come into God's presence. The Healing One empowers us to stand strong. Thanks be to God. Amen. We continue with this morning prayer, invoking the presence of the Holy Spirit. O God of all goodness, you welcome us, forgive us, and heal us. You seek us out from places where we have hidden from you, and you crown us with steadfast love and mercy. Reveal yourself to us in this moment. Let us know your presence that we may bless you. Bless you, O God. Bless your holy name. Amen. And our first lesson from the Hebrew Scriptures at the end of the first creation story, the book of Genesis. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed, for on the seventh day God had finished all the work of creation, and so on that seventh day God rested. God blessed the seventh day and called it sacred, because on it God rested from all of the work of creation. And our gospel lesson from Matthew's gospel. Are you tired, worn out, burned out on religion? Come to me and get away with me and you'll recover your life. I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me and work with me and watch how I do it. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me, and you'll learn to live freely and lightly. These are the words of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Well, friends, as we gather to record, of course, we're here on Wednesday evening, and we are fresh off of the presidential debates of last night. By Sunday, there will have been 5 more days of breathing room from that evening, and so we may feel a little bit differently than those of us that are here leading tonight feel right now. We may feel similarly. We can't tell how we're going to feel in 5 days. But I know that there is a mix of so many things going on, and it's important to acknowledge that. There's sadness. There is anger, there is weariness, there is fatigue, and all of us are looking for a word of hope, for that's what we're here to offer one another. In the midst of all this, we hear again the gospel words. Jesus says, "Come unto me, for you all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I will show you how to take a real rest." Our God, who creates order out of chaos and rests from all that God had made on the seventh day, calling us to remember our call to Sabbath rest, even in the midst of our week, and especially at least once a week. We've been talking about that for a bit now. We remember our Jesus who went off by himself to pray time and time again, who kept practicing his alone time with God throughout his ministry and calling his disciples, both then and us now, to do the same. Whether that was in the wilderness, into a place of unknown, and into many, many unknown situations, and with those whom he loved and knew the most. He kept practicing his time alone with God and calls us to do the same. As we're gathered together tonight, this last day of September, Who would have thought that 7 months ago we would be recording this service online for you? Could any of us have possibly imagined that? Could any of us have known this historic call to end so many years of systemic racism following George Floyd's murder and many others as well, our brown and black-skinned siblings that we share this earthly home with? Could we have ever imagined we would find ourselves in this time and place? It's what one of my colleagues, Frenchie McGee, who's one of the pastors at Hennepin Avenue UMC, has called a long existential scream. And I think that describes it very well. So I thank her for that. All, could any of us have imagined 7 months ago all the adaptation of our students and teachers and families still figuring out distance and hybrid and in-between sorts of things in learning? Could any of us ever imagine such a time? And the list continues as our daily lives unfold. And in the midst of that, we come together virtually and we come together in person as best we can to stay grounded in our faith, to stay grounded in our hearts and minds and our bodies and our souls. We come together to be the body of Christ. And it's so important in the midst of all of this, as the pandemic goes on, as the fight to end systemic racism, a dual pandemic goes on, as the days go on toward the election of our country's president and vice president, and all the other elected officials. What are these daily spiritual practices that are going to sustain us? And so I ask us these important questions. They're not new questions, but they're ones we need to be reminded of. Are we taking time for daily prayer and meditation, devotional reading of our holy scriptures and other devotional materials that speak to us? Are we exercising regularly? Are we noticing the beautiful things in creation like I was challenging the kids to do? That's for us big kids too. Are we paying attention to our nutrition? Are we paying attention to our social support as best we can? Are we paying attention to whatever feeds our souls? And quite importantly, are we remembering at the end of the day when we try to wind down to rest, are we stopping our screen time long enough before bed to rest our minds and spirits, or do we keep scrolling through our phones or our iPad? Any of us can fall prey to that. And so what I want to share with us tonight in light of all of that is a meditation prayer that was shared with us this week in a gathering of the Northwest Metro United Methodist clergy by our district superintendent, Susan Ritchie Nienaber. And these simple words spoke deeply to my soul, and I offer it to you as well as we ground ourselves in God's presence. And then I'll close with another prayer after that. If you just join me in an attitude of prayer. Pray through this three times with changing the words just a little bit. May I be safe. May I be healthy and strong. May I be happy. May I be peaceful and at ease. And may I be blessed by God this day. May you be safe. May you be healthy and strong. May you be happy. May you be peaceful and at ease. And may you be blessed by God this day. And a third time. May we be safe. May we be healthy and strong. May we be happy. May we be peaceful and at ease. And may we be blessed by God this day. This is our prayer. Amen. And one more prayer. prayer for courage before our choir comes up. This is from the wonderful writer John O'Donohue. For courage. When the light around you lessens and your thoughts darken until your body feels fear turn cold as a stone inside. When you find yourself bereft of any belief in yourself and all you unknowingly leaned on has fallen. When one voice commands your whole heart and it is raven dark, steady yourself and see that it is your own thinking that darkens your world. And so many other things. Search and you will find a diamond thought of light, and know that you are not alone, that this darkness has purpose. Gradually it will school your eyes to find the one gift your life requires hidden within this night corner. Invoke the learning of every suffering you have suffered. Close your eyes. Gather all the kindling about your heart to create one spark, for that is all you need. To nourish the sacred flame that will cleanse the dark of its weight of festered fear. A new confidence will come alive to urge you toward higher ground when your imagination will learn to engage difficulty at its most rewarding threshold. May this be our prayer. O God, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Jesus.
Jesus calls us to the well, inviting us to drink of the living water and the life eternal. Jesus calls us out of the shadows, out of the graves, to be entirely known and entirely filled with God's presence. Creator God, Mother and Father of us all, in your holy love you took on our limitations. Born of a body, born within a body, you know the whole of this human experience. Learning to communicate with words, teaching us to communicate with presence. Learning the fears that wring us dry, teaching us of the love that nurtures us back to life. Everlasting God, you are everywhere and right here. As close as the air we breathe, the air which binds us to one another and to all of your beautiful creation. You are as close as the sunlight on our skin and as close as the rain that drips from our hair, the wind and the water that push us and lead us and call us again and again into relationship with one another and with you. Holy Spirit, divine advocate, guide and encourage us. Stir within our hearts that we may speak anew the familiar words that Jesus taught us. Our Creator, who art in heaven and on earth, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the realm and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. In the symbol of the broken bread, we participate in the life of Christ and dedicate ourselves to being his disciples. For in the same way Jesus took the cup and after giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples saying, "Drink from this, all of you. For this is the cup of the covenant poured out for you and for many. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, God, we pray that your Holy Spirit would come and bless these elements, make them be for us the life presence of Christ, that we may be for the world the presence and power of Jesus. Through the Holy Spirit in God's holy church, whom we are here on earth, we pray. Amen.
Today, while the blossoms still cling to the vine, I'll rest in the beauty of blessings sublime, and knowing tomorrow will come as it may, I choose to I'll cherish
Greeting you for our drive through communion with a prayer station and some treats from our Seekers Youth Group. And on this day, we will be celebrating with our siblings in Christ around the world, and so we continue to join our hearts and lives together. As we go forth from this place, hear this blessing. Grain which was once scattered over the fields was brought together to feed us today. Grapes pulled from the vine squeezed to give us drink today. Now our time of worship and feasting draws to a close. Now we are dispersed like that grain, off to give the food of life to a hungry world. For we who have shared the banquet of hope go out as people connected to the vine, go out to bring the juice of life where the world has been drained dry. As people who have been fed, go now to feed the world. As those who have been given hope, bring hope in a place of despair. And may God help us to do so. And always remember that we are never cut off from the source. The bread of life, the true vine, is always with us. And so we always share in hope's banquet. Thanks be to the one who hosts the banquet. Amen. Go in peace.